Hey guys, I hope you are able to see my screen. So myself, to introduce myself, I'm Ravi Kiran. So working in as a software, started my career as a QA engineer and just bit by bit, and currently leading the product quality altogether called ConvoSight. So I've just worked on various technologies, starting from working with Angular apps, React apps, and in the back end, I just work with the various technologies like using a Python Django framework back end and Node.js and a .NET. And I even spend my time on integrating, automating the integration test as well. And right now, currently working on a serverless architecture for AWS. And so my domain was totally, my work basically was like, it's just solving the problem when and wherever required. It doesn't matter like what language, what framework is it is in. I believe in like our tests have to integrate with the same framework and the repo what devs are working on. So I believe in that philosophy, and just got myself got a chance to work in various technologies so far. So these are like this is a LinkedIn profile. I can just connect with me, and if you have any questions about like how to solve the issues like in your current project or any framework what you're talking about, can just help you out. And that's a GitHub repo of mine where I have some custom scripts like written how to solve some issues like social logging doesn't work in the Cypress. So I just have a repo, small repo where I used Play Live to log in, and I just continued the session taken from there and import it in Cypress and continue from there. So that's the kind of there are some other repos where I implemented Cucumber in using Cypress, and I've implemented again, Lighthouse to test the front end performance and all. So that's about it. And let's get into the topic. So today's agenda would be like, code coverage using Cypress. So why the code coverage is more important? As we have Cypress, just coming to the point about the code coverage using Cypress, like even the main drawback. As you guys know, like you're all probably came from Selenium background, right? So like Selenium Java. So we don't have much control on the application, like the where that would be hosted on a dev or staging or QA environment where and our test cases you would use to be run against that environment. But like right now with the Cypress, you have a lot more control on your project where you will be running that test against the local host. So this is something like before even the code is merged to the environment, you can just test and certify it like it is error it, without any error. So I believe like we have to get make much of it. So like so that before deploying it in any environment, there won't be any errors in the code. So I'll just tell you what is the code coverage initially. So code coverage is like obviously you can just see like the software testing that determine the number of lines of code which is being triggered by our test, like what? So basically, this is used by the mainly by the developers for the unit testing earlier, like. But right now, as Cypress, you have, like your test and the source code is there in the same browser itself. Like Cypress run the test in an iframe, implements in your core. The application in the iframe, so it's easier for us to get the metrics out of it. So and. The recipes what they have provided is very good. So I definitely recommend you for you to guys like go through this and implement in your own project. So that this is very important because there are less chances for you like go and check like if you have missed any conditions, like if you have some if else conditions in a statement, if you have not covered a test for that, like obviously you can just go and check and you would know like okay fine, I might have missed this case, and so that I can just automate it in the very next. So yeah, so what does the code coverage does is like it normally the line if you are just running the code and if the line is getting triggered in the application that is being recorded in the that is recorded in object, and that metrics will be given to us. And what Cypress does with their own plugin is that it gets the data out of that and creates a report for you, like what line has been triggered and what function and statements have been triggered. So normally, if you look at the code coverage report, these are all the aspects what you get, like get the functional coverage, how many functions have been called and a statement like what are all the statements have been executed and the branches like obviously if else normally all those branches are being executed and the conditions like how many conditions are there in the function and are the, is all the conditions are being covered and the line number of lines of source code have been tested. So this is basically how the code coverage normally the functionality of the code coverage would be, and this all this can be exported into a report for you. Okay, so how it is helpful for developers, this metric can help be helpful in dead code detection. Normally they write the unit test, and if they missed any scenarios in it, and they can just go and check and write the code for that. And even for the QS, it is very important because it helps us to detect the uncovered code scenarios, functional scenarios, and we can just write the test cases for that, right? So, and how it works normally. So suppose this is your basic function. Just suppose which adds a number. If you're given a two numbers, it adds and returns the value of it. So this is a function. To implement the code coverage, you have to instrument the application by yourself. Okay. So to do that, this is how the after the code is instrumented, this is how it looks like. So the window has a coverage object where a function of array is in made and statements of tree. Array is made and all once a statement is executed, it gets add like the number of times that statement or a function is being executed that is being recorded. So this is how it looks like. The function what we have written in the last slide, this is that will be modified in this way. Okay, so once we call the so in the normally when you have imported it, so now the function array the count is like zero because we have just imported the array, we haven't been triggered yet, so that's the reason the count is zero. And the next in the statement we have imported the statement here. So if you look at this first, so just above the function there is one statement array that is being triggered there, so that's the first trigger. So that's the line the count is incremented there, and at the bottom the last one is incremented there. So now you have S101. So but the main statement which returns the number is not been implemented, that's the reason you have 101. So and now after this, so now like you have written a test case for that. Now the even the function is being even the statement is executed. So now you have the function is executed with three statement, all the statements have been executed with all ones being covered. So this is like this is how the function is being measured like when you implement the code coverage. So to do that, you have to instrument the application yourself, and that has to be done by us. Cypress doesn't do that. They just record the code coverage. So instrumenting the application should be done by us. So before I begin, I just need to know like how many of you all like working with Angular or React or Vue.js project. Can you just mention that in the chat if possible? Anybody like, or else just going with the vanilla JS? Okay. Cool. So let's begin. So here I have implemented. I've shown the code for how to implement an Angular app and a React app. And I haven't got a chance to implement. Haven't got time to implement. Show the implementation in Vue app yet. So I've just given you the Angular app and React app here. So this is how you implement in an Angular app. So for this, you need like two packages where NGS build plus and Istanbul instrumental loader. So you just need to install these two packages. Okay. And this is a webpack. So normally what happens is like Angular uses webpack to convert your code to normally, to bundle the code all together. So we just need to add some extra config to that existing webpack. So this is how it looks like. So we're just telling the webpack to use the instrumental loader and all the paths like whatever given in it, and exclude some of it. So this all the JS and TF files in that will be instrumented. So once it is and in the angular.json, so we are, I mean, normally we have a default Angular builder, but here we are using NGX plus, because for the Angular builder you cannot give your custom webpack config to it, so it goes by the default. So to give an extra webpack config, what you are described in the previous slide, we use NGX build plus here, so only for the ngserv who are coming from the Angular background, they would know, like, so ngserv is nothing but like we run the server locally, okay, to run the server locally, and we are also giving some extra webpack config before the application is being served. So that, and we give the path to the extra webpack config, whatever we have given here. After that, so once you run the application like using ngserv, so this is how, like, you can so it will be implemented, but you can just check by going to the, once the application is deployed locally, so you can just go and check window.underscore_coverage. So in that you get all these files, like, so if you get this object, it means that your app is instrumented, okay? So just go for that. Next, coming now, the next is for the React app. So React app is like, it's very simple. So, I mean, compared to Angular, React, instrumenting React is very simple, because already Cypress has already given that. So you just need this only one package to instrument the React app. That's it. So Cypress instrument CRA. And next, all you have to do is just add this extra, you know, just before start, add this like React script -r @instrument Cypress instrument CRA. That's it. You don't need to add any extra webpack config, or everything will be done by them. So just one line of it. So now again, you can just go and check the same in the, this is the React app, to-do app. So this is just go and check it for yourself. So this is how it looks like. Okay. Now to implement, okay, fine. Now the instrumentation is being, is done. Now you have to get the results of whatever the instrumented results, you need to get it to Cypress. So for that, you need this package, like by Cypress again. So @cypress/code_coverage. And just import this in your index.js or index.ts, up to you, like, and later, you have to add it to the plugin, your index.js. So you just have to write this like, I mean, these are the, I would even provide you all these slides to it, and you just have to mention that in your module.export on config and written your config again after it is being done. Then later, so this is like a basic code coverage report. So this is a basic code coverage report before your tests are, I mean, this is just one to-do component where I haven't written any test for that yet. That's the reason it is showing you in, like, you know, all the red lines in it. So I've just seen, so the constructor is being called because we have rendered the page, and later you have like three methods in it. One on add to do, and on clear to do, and then one completing the task. Okay. So I haven't written any test to the test yet. So that's the reason it is showing in red in color. Okay. Now next. So now after the, I have written the test for on to do and on clear to do. Now see, look at the difference. Like, you know, earlier, I mean, it was coming in red color. Now it is coming in, I mean, all white. So like, I haven't written it for the completed task yet. So I think pretty much that's it. I'll just show you the application. Just give me a second. Right. So this is a basic to-do app. I think I'm just. Let me just share the screen altogether. Okay, so this is your basic to-do app. I just got the code locally here, and it has only one component, what to do, and this is the to-do component. Okay, now I have just show you the code here. So this is my webpack config where I've given it under the Cypress coverage.webpack.js, and later in the angular.ts, if you go to your build you can just see the difference here. This is the production. So here normally this is a default Angular dev kit normally you would use to build and you know serve the application locally or wherever. And now I'm here using NGX build plus dev server. Okay. And this is the extra webpack config which I've given the path here, and this would do the instrumentation and all. Okay. So let's run and check it now. It's compiled locally now. Can just check that in local. Yeah, this is your basic to-do app. Now it is live. If you just go, you can go and check whether you have the instrumentation or not here. This is the object which you get, so you can just check like the number of branches and the number of functions. You have one function, so one function. I mean, obviously it is being triggered now. I mean, I have done that earlier. So these are all the statements you have, three statements, and this is statement map you get. Now next, you go to let's run the Cypress application locally. So this is my spec. So what I'm doing here is like I'm just visiting the application. I have a small reusable component here to add to do, which it does is like, you know, just get the element and enter the text and just click on adding the button here. And I just created a custom data sieve. I hope you all guys know it, and they can just add this in all the components wherever needed. So here I'm just adding a to do and again removing a to do. Now you have no, okay, let's just delete them. Okay, now let me just run the text. So on every run, like, you know, code coverage report, they just reset the code coverage report first. Okay. So now this is being executed. Now we've got, so you have a coverage folder here. And this is the basic report, what you get. Okay. Here. If you look at that, I have implemented like 76% of code coverage. I've just implemented all these two, whatever the functionality of these two methods. And yeah, this is need to be done, which I haven't done. And if you could, now look at this, it's just like, it's just been decreased to 28%. Oh. Okay, just I think there is some error here. I think my implementation hasn't been done properly. So, but this is how normally it would work. I'll just check the error, like why it's been not happening so far. Probably I might have missed a case here. But normally what we are doing here is like, you know, we just doing it to do and removing it to do. Okay. So this is how it would be. Any questions?
Yes, Ravi. Regarding coming to the code coverage, does it applies to testers as well for using Cypress or only for its kind of unit testing with code coverage?
Well, it's not like that. See, like, I mean, just don't. Okay, fine. Let me come to the point. Like, why not? Why do you think like QS shouldn't use it? It's not like it's not only. I won't say like it's only for developers. At the end of the day, it's just for like to measure the code, like. To test the application code, what we are you know testing under. So I'm sure like all the QAs know like you cannot can't be 100% sure like you know you are writing that. I mean your tests are like 100% you know all the functionalities are being covered by your test. I'm definitely sure like all the QAs will have that in mind. Probably we might have missed one scenario and also, but. Using this measuring system, at least you would know, okay, fine, like this is one thing which I haven't tested so far. You can just go and check in the code, okay, fine, this function is not being tested. So here, like, you know, if you just look at the code normally, let me just give a minute. I'll just give you one example. Okay, here suppose on completing the test, you have like two, you have an if statement here, right? If this is completed, this both blocks are executed, and if else these blocks are executed. But on completing the task, probably you might have covered this scenario, but you might have missed this scenario in your test cases. How would you know? Like, you know, I mean, obviously, until and unless you get this bug in the production, you wouldn't know. Okay, fine, this functionality is broken, and we haven't covered it in the test case. But before that, at least you would know, right? I mean, like, okay, fine. These two lines are mapped in the test, in the, you know, in the code coverage, but not these two lines. Okay, fine. We might haven't. So you go and check your code and you see like, okay, fine. These two lines are not being covered because you haven't written a test case for that. So at least you can go and correct it by yourself. So I believe it plays a very important role in your, you know, being an automation engineer or because you will be like a team, right? Obviously your manual QA, probably he'll be giving you a test cases or else, I mean, if you're doing both the, I mean, two, I mean, being a manual and automation together, you might be writing the test cases by yourself and doing it. And if you're doing all the work by yourself, I believe this helps a lot. And thanks to Cypress team, and they have done an excellent job in implementing and whatever the tools needed for the testers.
Okay, Ravi, thank you. And there is one more question from Vaishali. Do we need to add line for code coverage in each test?
No. I mean, like, you don't need to add anything. You just have to instrument the application, and whatever the test you have written, it will be shown in the HTML. I mean, it will be shown in the code there. Like, okay, fine, you have written this test. So this code is being executed. Some part of code is being executed, and some are not. So you can just go and check it yourself. Okay, fine. I haven't written a test case, but you don't need to write anything there. I mean, I think I have kind of covered your answer. Like, you don't need to specifically mention any statements or lines or anything. It gives you bias. It's at all. I mean, the instrumenting the that package that does give you. I hope I have answered the question correctly. If anything, you can just put up a follow up question there.
Yes, Vaishali said thank you.
Okay, do you need any other? Right. Huh,
Guys,
okay.
any more questions? And Ravi, how long it will take for writing these code coverage tests?
I mean, it just, I mean, see, it's pretty simple, actually. I mean, you already have the code. I'll be sharing you this code as well. Hardly takes minutes, actually. If you have the repo locally, it hardly takes minutes. You just have to add this line and the config in your angular.json. And for React application, it's just like two lines of code. That's it. It hardly takes time for you. Just have to install the package and use it straight away.
Okay.
Ravi, Subhash this side. Just a quick question. Can you share once one more time the report? How does that look?
Okay, sure. You want me to share it in the slides or you want to check it by running the application?
I mean, anything works to me.
Okay. Okay. Let me just share the slide itself. I know why this might have happened. I think I just have to do some changes in this code itself. I'll do it later. So now you have this, I've implemented the code and this is your component. This is how it looks like. So this is just the, you know, this is nothing but your source code.
Sorry to tell, I mean, the screen, can you share up the screen?
Okay, is it not visible?
No, I mean,
properly? Okay, let me just zoom in, just give me a minute. How about now?
Perhaps not sure that, is it same for me? I can see up your face, but not the screen. So can you check that you are sharing up your screen?
Yeah. My bad, actually. Yeah. How about now?
Yeah, I can right now see that. Thanks.
Right. So this is your component .ts file. Normally, you know, right? I mean, how a single page application works. So the code, I mean, it all works with the JavaScript. That's it. I mean, so this is your main component .ts file.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like on to do text method, where normally what devs have implemented. And this is on clear method. So once what happens when you click on add to do button, you have this in your HTML here, like what happens when you click on to do and what happens when you click on this method gets implemented on click. Okay, and this method implements on, that's what happens when you click on a clear button. So that's what happening even with the with our code coverage. So we have implemented, written the test cases by adding a text. We have written the test case and added a to-do, right? So that's why this is in white in color, because see here, like you can see here, this has been triggered twice. This line is being triggered twice here, and even this and all. And here, this has been triggered once. Clear, because we have, this is being triggered twice because we have added a to-do and at the same time created a to-do. And even while implementing the create to-do, we have already also added the to-do. So that's the reason it is showing like this line is executed twice and this line is executed once. Okay, and init function is called four times because when you have visited the application, you have just checked once and there's a reason init function has been implemented twice for all the test cases. This is how the report would look like. And here you get this percentage normally. So all the 77 statements are executed with your test and 71% of function and 75% of lines. So, but I believe it's not like I believe, but I can say like you cannot achieve 100% code coverage here because there are a lot of limitations to that, but I would highly recommend at least you to try to achieve at least 60 to 70% first, because there are a lot of limitations in this. Actually, probably you might not have a lot of demo data with you. I would prefer for you to mock the data at least to achieve the code coverage. Even if you mock the data, it does add it in your front end instrumentation, and your code coverage would go up even if you mock the data. So just try to, you know, mock it wherever needed, and if something's like you can even write component level test cases as well, only for the component. It doesn't matter, like it doesn't communicate with your backend. It only you can just write the test cases only for that component only. I mean, like the functionality of it, like how, what happens when you click on a button and all that stuff, you can just test only for that component. So you can just pass in some dummy data. So obviously the component testing is nothing but kind of unit testing, but it's at the UI level, right? So even you can do it yourself as well. So if it is a React application with Redux, then you can just put in some state. You can just set the state for your React application and deploy your component, you can mount the component, and you can just test the functionality of it as well. So I think it's all up to you. Like, you have the tool, and whatever you want to do it with it, and how much you want to achieve. This can be even like, you know, showcase yourself as a QA engineer as well, right? I mean, like this percentage of your code is like tested. Like, I mean, you can just say like this 70% is being covered. So at least you can have that peace of mind in yourself. Like, okay, fine, nothing is broken. At least from the front end perspective. Obviously, for the back end, that's again a different. Like, you know, you have to write some integration test again for that.
Okay, thank you for the explanation. And we have few more questions. How to deal with iframes using Cypress?
Iframes, right? Okay, so. You have another package already actually for the iframe. I have implemented that in one of the test cases, but it's not straightforward. And I think I'm not even sure whether the code cover. I mean, obviously, iframe is nothing but like kind of other project altogether, right? So even that code won't be covered. That won't be covered as part of your code coverage. So that's again a different project altogether. If you have an iframe, that's again a kind of a different web view altogether. So you can also instrument that application altogether, and you can just merge both the reports together and make it one report. So if you want to only deal with how to write the test cases for iframes, I think I can give you some examples later, but right now I don't have the code with me right now. I can give you some examples like how to deal with that later. I can make a small repo and probably you can just have it by yourself.
Okay, Ravi, that sounds good. And one more question, does this support any other than Angular or React?
It does have a Vue. I mean, obviously these three are the like most leading frameworks right now for the front end. And vanilla JS, I haven't got a chance to work with the vanilla JS so far, but I'm sure, like, I mean, if see end of the day, if you have the source code with by yourself, you can instrument it. That's straightforward. That's it. So all it matters is like it has to be deployed locally, and you should have that access to make the changes in your source code.
Okay, Ravi, thank you for the explanation. Guys, any more questions? You can unmute yourself and straight away ask to Ravi regarding the questions if you have any queries or doubts. And Deepak is asking, like, can provide iframes with example for multiple iframes.
Multiple iframes. So what do you mean by multiple iframes? Like, you have it, you have a page, and if you click on a button, you get an iframe. Then again, you have one more iframe inside that, or else you have two iframes on the same source page. I just need that. So obviously, I think we are out of that topic here, but you can definitely deal with multiple iframes as well. I'm sure about that because I have already worked on that, but I don't have the code with me right now to show it to you exactly, but that was on a different project altogether. Any more questions, guys?
I think that's all for the questions, Ravi. So
okay.
As you mentioned, like you will share the Git repo, right? Regarding the examples and
you want it for code, I mean, like for this Angular and React applications? Yes, I can do that.
Yes, could you please share the link so all the participants will go through and we'll get some idea.
Sure. I think even the slide, whatever I've prepared right now, even that would be enough. Like, I mean, I have covered everything in that. If you still want a repo, I don't mind doing that. I mean, I just have to push the code to a new repository. That's it.
Okay. I mean, it is an open source, right? Open source Git repo, right?
I mean, my own personal account, like in GitHub. I mean, it's a public repository.
Public repo, right? Okay, yeah. Noted.
Yeah. Okay.
So, Suraj, you have any questions to Ravi?
No, I mean, I'm pretty done from mine. Thanks, Ravi, for that. Such a wonderful explanation.
I mean, it's my first time as well, guys. So please bear with me. Like, I'm not used to like teaching and all. So probably I might be doing a better, you know, in explaining the things probably in the next step if I do again one thing.
Sure, Ravi, we'll come up with a new session in future as well.
Okay, I have a question here from Deepak. How we do integration testing through that? Okay. What do you mean? You can just unmute yourself and ask the question, not a problem. We can just discuss.
Thank you. But I'm in the valley. So for just meeting your communications on focusing the code. So
sorry,
why is not here? So I'm
Deepak, I haven't understood actually. Can anybody explain it?
I mean, Deepak is saying like, sorry, Deepak, your voice is breaking. So is your question how we do integration testing through it? Okay, Ravi, Deepak is asking how to do integration testing through it.
Through Cypress, you mean, right?
Through Cypress, yes.
Yes, okay, so see, Cypress, end of the day, it's just a browser. So what Cypress all communicates with the browser. So it makes same XHR calls and it has a functionality for that as well, using cy.api, where you can make all your API calls and assert them, like, you know, whatever the response you get it. So it's again like plain JavaScript. I think if you still need an example, probably I might have to again make a new repo for that. But it's just a plain REST client, like, you know, how it happens with any Express or Axios or anything, other packages. It's all the same. It's nothing, anything specific. But it happens with the browser, but yeah. You have some limitations with the integration test using Cypress API as well. You don't have a straightforward, I think for form data, I guess, like if you want to upload any form but data or something like that, it doesn't have a straightforward implementation using cy.api. So that, again, you have to use the Windows XHR object inside, and I have to make the call using that. Other than that, I think pretty much you have all of them are being covered in the cy.api itself. And what kind of application, what kind of integration test, is it like kind of a REST API or is it a GraphQL, I mean, XML, what it is exactly?
Deepak, are you looking for any specific requirement? Payment domain.
Payment domain, okay. Okay, so I hope it would be a REST API itself, because payment domain data, I mean, maybe, or if it is an old one, probably it would be XML. But you can do that. I mean, there are a lot of examples actually in that. I mean, I don't have a proper report to share you right now with you, but I mean, I hope it's pretty much, it is like, it's pretty straightforward actually. You can just do it yourself. There are a lot of examples out there. I mean, you can just try doing it yourself, and if you still have any errors in between, obviously I can help you out. I mean, you can just reach me anytime. You can connect through LinkedIn and you can just ask the questions. I do answer a lot of questions actually in the, there are a couple of groups in LinkedIn as well regarding the Cypress test automation. So you can just join that and put in your questions, and obviously I'll be there as well. There are a lot of other people as well to answer your questions.
Any okay, Ravi. Yeah. So, any more questions, guys?
Okay.
So, that's all from the participants, Ravi. So, once again, like, thanks for joining us today and explaining about code coverage about for the React and Angular applications. So, hope we'll connect in future as well for the Cypress series.